came out here and, you know, you guys entered the red zone, I think, 5 times and went away with field goals each time. Obviously, that's a little less than ideal, but how'd that work out for you guys?
Well, I mean, you know, it certainly great talent on both sides of the field. And, you know, this was a tough 2 weeks because, you know, this past week, schools were closed Monday and Tuesday. We couldn't practice. We couldn't practice on Wednesday because the facility that we used was snow covered. So, and then you got, and again, these kids are involved in a lot of stuff, wrestling, basketball. So we only had 8 practices, but we never had anybody there at any one time. And you know, it's a credit to these kids how they, you know, adapted, you know, what we put in, you know, in a short period of time. And the assistant coaches did a great job. And again, with the continuity, you know, it's a passing game. And you got to work the timing and everything. And then you get into the red zone, and sometimes you're not ready for that. But, you know, we won the battle of the field position and, you know, took the points that we needed to get when we needed them. So.
Well, speaking of the passing game, I mean, with the cold, with the snow that we had earlier, with the fact that the teams haven't had that much time to work together, you'd normally think you'd want to just run the ball straight up the middle a lot, but it seems like you guys had all the route tree available to you. So what was the decision to, like, be passing constantly?
I mean, it's a passing game. I mean, you've got talented, skilled kids. You know, everybody on this field, there's a reason why they're here. And, you know, to line up in a, you know, an eye, and, you know, just to smash it, you know, we want to showcase these kids' talents. And they're good enough football players that they can adapt, even though it's a new system. And you know, I give credit to Brad Wilson. You know, he put together the wristband, so we didn't have to huddle, which helped us, I think, a little bit. But, you know, overall, considering the crazy week with the weather and all that, I thought both teams played great. And it was going to come down to, matter of fact, we were teasing Alex as the night, told him coming out here. I said, Alex, you know, we're going to win this game 3-0. You know, because that's when it started to snow and, you know, the bad weather. So, you know.
Talk about how you feel. I mean, it's a lot of fun to go out in your last game, in an all-star game.
I mean, you know, I told the guys, I said, you know, when I put together my coaching staff, I said, you know, a lot of the coaches that I had were friends of mine from a long, long time, you know, and I wanted to be with them, you know, for the, you know, my last coaching game. And you know, I was teasing Rick Connor from Lingendorf because he just lost in the 3A state championship. And he called me and he goes, are we ready? He goes, I think we are. He says, well, I'm not going out my last 2 games with losses. And I said, I think we'll be fine. But it's special. And it meant, you know, a lot to me because, you know, from personally speaking, I got to, you know, coach my son in his last football game. And it just really special. But we kept it low key. You know, before we came out to the field, you know, I've tried to keep it light with the kids and have fun. And I got them all in. I mean, I said, you know, here's my pregame speech. I got one word to say to you. And I said, Aflac, like that commercial. And then they started laughing. They looked at me like, this guy alluding to it. I said, hey, this game is about fun. I said, this is to showcase your talent and have fun. I said, if you walk off this field without a smile on your face, win or lose, I'm disappointed. And, you know, I think we had a lot of smiles. So, you know, I think everybody's leaving happy.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.